my channel, my friends. Today I'm gonna do a video all about running. So I don't know why I haven't done this video sooner, but I used to do 100 meter hurdles and then I went on to do ultra endurance events like the Ironman. So I've kind of gone from like one extreme to the other, and I learned some really great tips on the way because I've had some amazing coaches for both like running styles. Honestly, with running, we could go on forever about stride, being really picky about biomechanics, etc. But I don't wanna do that because otherwise we'll be here for like 24 hours and you guys don't have time for that. So these tips are gonna be tips that you can implement straight away and you should see improvements in your running. But if you do wanna take your running to the next level, then I do recommend you guys go see an athletics coach or go to a running club and they can give you like specific tips based on your body. So we're gonna cover three different speeds. So sprinting, middle distance, long distance. And then I also wanted to cover uphill running and downhill running because I learned some little tricks as well when I was doing trail running. So maybe that can help you guys as well. And actually, believe it or not, downhill running is harder than uphill running. Like, it's weird, but it actually is. But anyway, we'll get into that later on. If you like this video, give me a big thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button if you want to join this amazing family. And yeah, we'll get straight into it. I wanted to run with my spikes today, but Mario said that was being too extra. So I'm just gonna be running with normal training shoes. So we're gonna start off with sprinting. It's our fastest speed, we're going all out. And to be honest, I feel like this one's quite helpful because a lot of you guys always tell me that you like to do sprints in your HIIT workouts. So this might help you to get the most out of your HIIT workouts as well. I'm gonna work from the top down in terms of tips. So one of the things that's really important when you sprint is you don't wanna be feeling too tense. You want the tension to be going in the right spots, but you don't wanna be tensing everywhere. Like, tensing your jaw doesn't help you sprint, so try and keep that relaxed. Head is nice and neutral, you're just gonna be looking straight ahead of you. Your neck is gonna be nice and long because you're not, again, gonna be tensing your shoulders. You wanna keep your shoulders down and that's gonna help you move your arms. Your elbows are gonna be at 90 degrees the whole time and you really wanna use them. This is where I see people not using their arms. They just kind of half use their arms and then some people cross the body. That only works when you're accelerating in your sprint start, but when you're actually in the phase of sprinting, you really want to be keeping it parallel and really brushing past so you can really drive forward with the arms. Super important. Your core is going to stay nice and braced. It's really important to brace your core because that's going to keep your body nice and upright when you're sprinting. So your knees are gonna come up nice and high, again, parallel with the body. So once you then extend the knee and that becomes like your back leg, you really use the glutes to drive and extend so that your back leg is straight behind you. In terms of feet, when you're sprinting, always land on the balls of your feet. Super important. You don't want to be landing on the heel or the midfoot when you're sprinting. It's going to be balls of your feet. One thing that I find is quite helpful if you feel like you're struggling with your sprinting is trying to improve your range of motion. So very often, and I had this when I was doing a lot of like bodybuilding training and I was just targeting like muscle mass, I actually didn't have a huge range of motion. So that meant that my knee wouldn't come up as high or my elbow wouldn't go as far back to drive me forward when I'm sprinting. And also I just felt quite tight all round and I couldn't really relax. So trying to improve flexibility can be a really helpful thing, especially if you want to try and improve your running to make it feel like a natural thing again. Now we're gonna cover middle distance running technique and then also finish off with some tips that might help you guys for your middle distance running. In terms of like distances covered, I feel like this is very different for different people. In athletics, it's usually like 800 meters to 3000 meters, upper to like 5000 meters. But then if you're a road runner, like 10K will be a middle distance. But yeah, middle distance is that kind of distance where you're still kind of really pushing yourself over a much longer distance. It's not really a sprint. In terms of technique, there are some real similarities with sprinting. So still the theme of staying relaxed, trying to direct that tension in the right areas of the body to make your running as efficient as possible still holds true. But there are some things that do distinguish middle distance running from sprinting in the sense that you're not going to be pumping your arms as much as when you sprint. So your arms do still stay relatively close to your body, but you're not gonna be pumping them as high. So they're just gonna kind of still be pumping you forward, but they're just not coming up as high. That's just gonna waste a lot of energy, especially if you're doing it over a longer distance. Also, your knees don't come up as high, so you're not gonna be driving the knees up as high when you're doing a middle distance run. They're just gonna kind of stay a little bit lower when you're running. In middle distance, we want both power and efficiency. So when you're running upright, it's more power. When you're running forward, it's more efficient. So it's just about you finding what works better for your body and what you prefer. Some people will run better with a more forward-leaning posture, and some people will run better with a more upright posture. Really, it just depends what you prefer, and it's definitely worth trying both over a middle distance to see what feels more natural for you. In terms of your feet, you're still going to be running on the balls of your feet because it's still quite a fast-paced run. You can, if you're starting to get tired, start landing on the ball to midfoot, but I do recommend you trying to build the stamina up to always land on the balls of your feet, because that's going to give you the quickest speed when you're doing a middle distance run. In terms of tips, it's really important when you're doing middle distance running to focus on your technique the whole time. As soon as your technique starts to drop, that's when it's gonna become like harder for you to run efficiently. And if you're losing the technique, you're already tired, but it's gonna take even more energy to complete that run. So yeah, really important to stay focused and to not exhaust yourself at the beginning and risk losing good technique later on in the race. And also, it's really important to strengthen your calves, but also to have really good flexibility in your Achilles, because those are going to be put under a lot of strain when you're doing like a middle distance run. Those are the kind of the two biggest tips I suggest when you're doing middle distance running. But most importantly is to really stay focused. Now we're going to talk about long distance running. Now, for some great long distance runners like Mo Farah, they actually run with a middle distance running technique, but that's just because they're so quick that that technique makes sense for them. For us, sometimes we just want to be running just to enjoy it, and we just want to keep going for longer. So in these cases, in terms of technique, it's important, again, the whole theme of staying relaxed is still valid. So you still want to have like a relaxed face, your shoulders are nice and relaxed, so that the tension is going in the right parts of the body to help you keep running efficiently. So let's start with the chin. Like, because we're running for so long, you want to keep your chin upright, because if you keep your chin up too high or too far down, it's going to constrict your airways, and it's also going to alter the posture of your back. So you want to keep your chin relatively upright and straightforward. If you feel like you like looking downwards, which is fine, just move your eyes downwards. Don't move your whole head downwards. When you're running, try and keep your arms parallel and tight, because otherwise you're just gonna be expending unnecessary energy and you're just gonna be like rotating all over the place. So that's not helpful. So you do wanna keep them kind of parallel, quite tight to the body. In terms of your posture, you wanna be kind of running upright but with a slight lean forward. So running upright is great because it means that you can get all that oxygen in, and over a long period of time, that oxygen is gonna add up. But if you land too upright, then you're gonna compromise the biomechanics. When you land, your foot's gonna land in front of your center of gravity. So what's gonna happen by default is you're just gonna create like a braking force, and that's gonna need energy from your quads to kind of pull your center of gravity forward so that you go forwards. And you're gonna start fatiguing your quad muscles. If you have a slight lean forward, then it's helpful because it kind of uses gravity to your advantage. You can land where your center of gravity is in front of your foot, so you're always kind of going in like a forward motion. That means that there's no braking power being applied and your body is ready to fall forward so that you can keep going forward. But you don't want to lean too far forward, because that will then create strain on your lower back, and it will also compromise your breathing. You won't be taking in as much air, so it might make it harder for you on the later stages of your run. Overall, the idea is that you want to run tall, but if you can use a little bit of lean forward, then you get the best of both worlds. Next up, in terms of your knees, like, they stay slightly bent and they're just not going to come up as high as middle distance running. And then with your feet, you want to be landing from the heel to the midfoot and then quickly rolling forward. The more ground contact you have, the slower you'll be. So if you can be quick on and light on your feet, then the quicker you'll be along the run as well. Now, just in terms of some tips you can use that can help make your run more enjoyable, in terms of breathing, I find it helpful to inhale for 3 steps and then exhale for 2. That just helps me find like a regular breathing routine. It kind of becomes second nature after a while, but at the start it really helped because my breathing was all over the place, and over a long race that can really like add up. And then another tip that I find really helpful that I actually mentioned in the other like running styles is to strengthen your hip flexors. Doing some hip flexor work at home or in the gym if you want to can really help strengthen the hip flexors. Means that you can keep bringing your knees up and running with correct form rather than actually just fatiguing and then you drop your form and then the whole run just becomes really unenjoyable and could also potentially lead to injuries as well. While we're talking about long distance running, I also wanted to give you a few technique tips that might help you when you go uphill or downhill. So when you're going uphill, it can really help to kind of lean a little bit into the hills. Like I mentioned before, when you're running on the flat, you still wanna stay really relaxed, even though you're gonna be working a little bit harder. Also, your arms are gonna help so much because when you're going uphill, you can actually use your arms to propel you upwards. Your knees as well need to come up a little bit higher so that you can really cover that upward ground. You wouldn't be going upstairs if you didn't bring your knees up higher, so it's a little bit similar when you're going up a hill and you're going to go onto the balls of your feet to really help drive you upwards. And in terms of stride length, your stride length is going to be a little bit shorter and you want to keep a relatively quick cadence. So if you think about it, your feet are going to be stepping quicker, but you're actually going to be slowing down just because you've got a huge obstacle in the way. So once we've gone up the hill, there is eventually going to be a downhill section. So this one is kind of dependent on how you want to go about it. If you want to use it as a break, then it can be really helpful to kind of lean back a little bit or be a little more upright and then land with your feet from heel and roll onto your toes. That can kind of act as a break and it can minimize some of the impact. If you want to go a little bit faster and use that gravity to really propel you forward, then lean a little bit into the heel and go from midfoot and roll onto the balls of your feet and use your arms for balance. Running downhill is actually quite taxing on the legs. It's called eccentric loading. You're actually adding stress to the muscle when it's elongating rather than contracting. In both cases, however you want to take it, easy or a little bit faster, make sure that you're still staying nice and relaxed. I know I feel like I've said that so many times, but also keep your core engaged and yeah, just enjoy the scenery around you, because usually when you're going downhill it means that you can enjoy the view. I always like the view, and here we've got a lovely view of London. I'm just redoing the hair because all of this running hasn't kept up. Anyways, I'm gonna end this video. I don't know why I did my hair for the outro, but anyways, I'm gonna end this video. I hope you guys found those techniques and tips really helpful. Let me know if you guys implement them, if it helped you increase like one of your PBs. Let me know, I always love to hear your achievements. So if you like this video, give me a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button. I love you so much and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.